Hello, it's the tarot reading for the collective. Definitely feel like there's some pertinent information. Feeling something in the air here. Hermit reversed, Ten of Swords. Someone doesn't want to be ostracized. They feel defeated, ruined, some sort of painful ending. Or this is what someone did to you, or this is someone acting rashly and now they're going through some type of painful ending, or they don't want to be alone. Fill face down. Wow, justice. So someone's dealing with karma. I don't feel like they want you to know about it, because a lot of time when they fall face down, I always take it like someone doesn't want you to know. Four of Pentacles reverse. They have to let go of something, or this is because of greed. Someone was power hungry, or someone... Someone's in denial about something, and they're moving very quickly towards someone. Or someone's really in denial about someone moving quickly towards someone. Someone's in a lot of regret. The Hermit. Something about someone investigating something or someone, or spending a lot of time. That Knight of Swords could be law enforcement, tower, some sort of shocking situation, shocking for the person experiencing it, or shocking to witness. I mean, someone could be, you know, getting hauled to jail in a police car in front of all the neighbors. I mean, this feels dramatic. Ten of Swords, Tower, Justice. If it's not something like that, it feels like that. It feels very, like a huge event. It feels, there's like a big, big thing happening. Someone feels like their whole life is in shambles, or it's all falling apart. It's painful. Very, very painful. Tower and Justice. Also someone, I mean, experiencing karma, and this is the result of it, whatever's falling apart here. Seven of Wands reversed, they can't defend themselves. They have no excuse, or there's no help. Nine of Pentacles is the problem. Somebody's still standing, or somebody's very independent. Maybe someone told some type of a lie. Maybe this is like a legal issue. This is the courts, Justice. And there's something about you being very stable that is very significant. Someone can't defend themselves in the subconscious. Something is backfiring, I feel like. Four of Swords. Someone is thinking very deeply about this. Hermit and Four of Swords. They might have a lot of time to think about something here, especially if they're getting hauled away to jail. I don't know if that's what's going on here, but... Or it feels like it. It feels dramatic and painful. It's something about someone not committing to someone that someone loves. Or someone being seen as irresponsible, or someone loves someone. Someone definitely loves someone. Or irresponsible with a child could be also Knight of Pentacles reverse, Page of Cups reverse, or slowing down someone they love, or trying to slow down someone they love. Two of Cups, there's something about a perfect match, some sort of partnership here. So this is like Death reverse, a crime of passion. The Tower. This is a big deal. Tower and Justice. Five of Pentacles. Someone's out in the cold. They could lose everything. Or this is a dark night of the soul. This is all either an emotional tower, or there's some event happening here. It's definite. When Justice is right in the center, that's the central issue. I don't know if someone is shocked by karma, or shocking events because of karma. Shocked by the truth, waking up, everything's crumbling, they lost everything. This is a huge mess. It's a huge mess. Eight of Pentacles in the recent past, something to do with somebody working. Nine of Pentacles reverse. Someone here being very irresponsible, non-committal. Some type of news or messages or someone trying to get out of a nightmare. Nine of Pentacles reverse. Someone's non-committal. They want out of a nightmare. They feel rejected. Someone doesn't want to plan with someone. They're not making plans with someone. Someone wants to move forward and follow their passion. Hierophant reverse. Maybe someone wants a divorce and that's what this is. The Star. Someone could be looking at someone that they find inspiring. Who's, you know, whose light is really shining. Someone that gives them hope, or they see you in this hopeful energy, and you seem like maybe you've got a protective energy around you. Someone that's real smart and can see everything, or this person feels like someone's been watching them or sees them. Maybe online. This has to do with travel. Someone's definitely stuck in a drama based on their ego, or they don't feel like they're going to be able to withstand this. It has to do with someone loving someone or a child. Intentions, expectations, the Chariot reverse. I know someone could be planning on doing something that, you know, doesn't make any sense to try to create. It's just a hectic, chaotic movement to try to shake something up, or someone feels like they've completely lost control of their environment. There's no way to push forward with maybe a marriage, or there's a group here that's experiencing this. Someone's definitely stuck, Hanged Man, because of a truth or clarity. Yeah. Ace of Pentacles reverse. In the near future, someone's taking a loss. I feel like they keep taking losses. I feel like this is another loss, or they're really focused on a huge loss that they had, and that's all that is like absorbing them. Ace of Cups reverse. Someone feels empty inside. Someone doesn't love someone. In the environment. Wow, High Priestess reverse. So there could be someone who is, if this is a masculine energy, they could have a High Priestess reverse around them, projecting at them. Or this reading, this could be a High Priestess reverse who's going through a tower. And with this High Priestess reverse in the environment, that means that everyone can see that they're a High Priestess reverse. So something could be coming up and out about something that this person has done. That is very insidious, witchy. Yeah. And it's all because of that someone loves someone, or someone finds someone to be someone's happiness. Someone's going through a tower because someone loves someone. This person could have been working away, trying to create some sort of inequity with a group of people, or trying to draw someone away with some sort of seductive energy, create some sort of confusion, create fighting, arguments, tension. This person could be in competition with you. There could be a lot of discord over someone being non-committal. And now someone is stuck. Someone that was trying to hide something is stuck, or someone's trying to keep it hidden that they're stuck. It all has to do with someone loving someone here. The Moon, Hanged Man. And this could also be someone that there's something going on with a child where someone's in trouble. But I feel like this has to do with someone that really loves someone. The Hanged Man, the Moon, Page of Cups. They could feel like they're really unstable. Like they can't get a hold of themselves. Someone could be trying to hide their feelings for you. And they feel like they're gonna lose it. They feel like they can't handle what's happening to them. That's that Ten of Swords feeling. They could be watching someone else come towards you. Yeah, a Knight of Cups coming towards a Queen of Cups. And they feel rejected. Or there's a High Priestess reverse that is with someone here that has feelings for you, doesn't want to commit to them, wants a divorce, wants to come towards you. Well, they're watching someone else come towards you. Someone, you seem to see this person. You seem to see this person. It's almost like someone not wanting to be rejected is standing in the way. That could be someone's perspective. But I feel like someone could be feeling rejected because of the way you look at someone, or someone loves you. Two of Pentacles, Temperance. You could be very busy, and there could be a good mix, a good match between you and someone else. There could be a lot going on. Very busy, but it's still a good match. Or a lot of changes in the air. And it's like you're handling everything with ease, or there's like a healing energy around you. It's very busy. Someone's witnessing that or aware of it. Hopes and fears, Two of Pentacles. A lot of changes, busy, keeping the balls in the air. Someone juggling someone. It's something to do with you. A Queen of Cups, someone that someone sees as like a sweetheart that's very kind, empathic, that someone sees as their happiness. Someone did something unfair here. Someone that was in denial, or someone tried to create a stalemate, who's jealous. Someone tried to create a stalemate or create a blockage between you and someone else that was jealous. Someone could be realizing that there was a whole plan here. That could be the Tower. There could have been a lot of lies. Someone that was jealous or obsessive. There could be someone here that's obsessed now and that's in denial. Someone wants to move or come towards you, and they feel like someone else is in the picture, or that they can't save it, they can't fix it. This could have to do with finances. It could do with a lot of finances, a lot of resources. A Two of Cups that's connected to a Ten of Pentacles. So some sort of partnership that manifests a lot of abundance. There's just a lot of abundance around this partnership. Lovers reverse, someone wants a divorce. They want to come towards a Queen of Cups, or there's a group here. There's something about your patience, your healing energy, and a breakup. And someone here being very irresponsible or non-committal. Maybe someone's thinking about how patient you were with them. How patient. Maybe you waited for someone to figure something out for a while. And someone is seeing it, and they're realizing what happened. I feel like there's someone else here, not just this person, that wants to come towards you also fell face down. We have a Ten of Pentacles. So there could be a lot of money that was driving someone that someone doesn't want someone to know about it, or they don't want someone to know that they're focused on their ten of Pentacles. Some sort of a breakup. Five of Pentacles, someone's out in the cold. This could also be you keeping your, you know, your business yourself as far as what you're building. The Tower, someone could be feeling like there's some sort of a spiritual connection between you and them, and that it has to do with abundance and building something together, and now they feel out in the cold and they're going through a tower because you're the one. They feel out in the cold emotionally, and they feel like they're missing their blessing, that they lost their blessing, that they were tricked. So we have Tower in the upright under the deck. So you have this femme fatale energy. It's part of it. I feel like this is this High Priestess reverse. Someone who's overly attached to money and power. Some sort of karma playing out here. Dilettante. There could be religion involved. Femme fatale, dilettante. This is someone who exploits the female nature in form. Now someone feels like a beggar. Somebody was wearing a mask. Someone is in denial or was denying an emotional truth. Something about someone maybe dibble-dabbling around in energies that they shouldn't be, up to some weird, strange things. There could be addictions here. Someone addicted to trying to steal something from you. Something completely illogical was going on. Somebody was dibble-dabbling in some sort of lower vibrational spiritual activity or something like that. This could be a father figure that feels like they're failing. Someone is not this child magical. Someone could feel like they've fallen from spiritual grace, or like someone was a shapeshifter here. It seems like it's all falling apart. Something is going on with someone's entire network as well. And it's all because, you know, it's like someone can't believe it. You're so sweet and kind. There's something here about a student gossip, someone gossiping about a student, or a student that's gossiping, or someone here isn't interested in money only. Someone here has like a rebellious spirit. Someone here seems very very much like a guide. Someone could be an athlete or very athletic. Someone here could be an artist. Someone here could be a pioneer. Someone that starts new things. Someone judged you wrong, and they were coming from this very hedonistic place. Someone that was like a mentor, or someone aligned themselves with someone that seemed like a mentor, but it was all for self-aggrandizement, self-satiating energy. Someone could be a writer here that's involved, or something that someone wrote something down. There could be a lot of texting, emails, letters, something that someone wrote, or trying to keep some information going, you know, but it's really bullying someone. Someone here had a God complex, and someone has a gambling problem potentially. There's something about someone trying to destroy someone's chivalrous energy, or destroy somebody's chivalry. Yeah. It's like with all of this, there's like all of this overcomplicated, way complicated, and then you have just this very kind of simplistic energy with this temperance and the Queen of Cups. There's something about you being very pure at heart, very balanced, kind, loving person. And now it doesn't seem so simple, or I feel like someone felt like there was something about this that wasn't maybe as strong as you are, or that someone missed something here with this. They missed a lot with this. Queen of Cups energy. How is this justice playing out? Right, reverse. Something that someone was trying to do that's very manipulative is backfiring. Someone was trying to create some sort of a daydream. Or they wanted someone to be in some sort of a daydream. Something that was very manipulative. It's like something is falling apart. It was so that someone wouldn't help someone. Someone was telling someone what to do, like a mentor. Justice karma is playing out. There was some sort of strategy to block some sort of chivalry or commitment here. There's some sort of justice playing out for a vow that someone took. Justice. The form this justice is playing out is in with loss, bereavement, sorrow, damage. So yeah, this does feel like this Ten of Swords event. It's heartbreaking. And there's something about marriage or sweet love, someone wanting to marry you, or someone seeing you in a relationship, or someone heading towards you. Something being very sweet and peaceful around you. Marriage. There could be someone here who's thinking a lot about, they could have had this sweet love with you. It's like when you stub your toe and all you want is just for the pain to go away. You just want neutral. It's kind of like that. There's a loss of like innocence or loss of sweet, that just the memory of the simple sweet love. There was no fancy stuff. It just was true love. Something about that, the loss is like horribly painful to someone. They might have believed some sort of lies about you, or they see it as a blessing now. Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, daydream, eternal love. There's someone here dreaming about you. And eternal love. Yeah, they see you. Eternal love, daydream. Someone sees you as like, you know, their soulmate. You could have been very consistent with someone. Now I feel like someone's thinking about wanting to be this with you, though. Not so much about memories. They're thinking about someone who is very stable and independent, made something of themselves. That's a Queen of Cups. Somebody could be feeling crushed because someone else feels that's this way about you. That's not this ex as well. Someone has experienced, I feel like someone has a loss of love, and that is the justice. I feel like that's the simplest interpretation here. Justice, loss, eternal love. And you persevering, you being very perseverant with this sweet dream, living and learning, some sort of karma playing out connected to this. It feels like you didn't get bitter from something that someone did. Someone should have treated you better. A lot better. Someone's getting demasked here. That's part of the karma. Now we have the dog howling to add to the soundtrack of the reading. Someone feels like they went into something blind. Or someone that tried to blind someone to something. Some sort of strategy that someone had here. There's karma playing out for that. They don't win. You're too perseverant. And there's all this conflict here about someone with a family, or someone doesn't care about someone. And there's a lot of people involved. Overindulgence here. Someone feels like they wasted all their time. They can't relax. With this alliance, these people, it feels really empty. Very, very empty. It's either someone can't manipulate you, or someone can't manipulate you. This was a trap. I feel like someone wants to compromise on some kind of manipulative energy here. But whatever this is, karma's playing out. Someone might feel like they need help. You could be in a relationship where someone wants to come towards you. Leave a collaboration where there's no money, or it's just there's meanness here. This focus on this fantasy about luxury is like all falling apart. It has to do with this group of people, some sort of clique that someone made a vow to. They have a goal, and you're very perseverant. So you're in this sweet dream energy, and someone feels injured, or someone got injured. It seems like you're building something here, or that's the goal. You're building towards something bigger. You're building something that's Ten of Pentacles. And you're not afraid of what someone was doing. Someone can't defend themselves from trying to bully you. There's something kind of like impossible for someone to fully process, having to do with how sweet you are, and that they're the ones that are, you know, getting knocked around. So it's like the bully is feeling bullied, but it's not by you. It's like you didn't do anything to anyone here, and you were very non-reactive and peaceful. I feel like there's something also about you transmuting energy here. You're not in a disaster, you're relaxed. So I don't know what... These people can't relax, this group. Someone's realizing that the whole thing's a trap. Something about you being very alert and awake, or it feels like you're always there, like ahead of them, miles ahead. It's like you get there before they're going to do whatever the plan or strategy it is. They can't stop you. Someone's seeing how some sort of an adventure is injuring them. Eight of Pentacles reversed in the recent past. Someone is putting the work in. Training, developing themselves. I feel like this is you. Someone's realizing they... So something is a trap, trying to, manipulate you or go against you. There's also some sort of evidence of somebody trying to tempt someone, having to do with work or something like that. They keep seeing that this is not a lucky situation, and someone wants to compromise. This is all getting very disturbing. Chariot reverse, someone feels like they lost control. They feel cursed, like they didn't win. There's a lot of conflict here, they can't get along. Over you being so perseverant, it's bad news. Ace of Pentacles reversed, they're taking a loss in the near future. It has to do with some sort of sweet love that you're in, or someone that wants to come towards you, or is coming towards you, or someone's getting married, and they feel like they're losing, and they don't have the money. This whole collaboration is failing. Some sort of strategy and ideas on how to live some sort of adventure. You're ready. You're very sweet and relaxed and also ready. For whatever the next plan is. Someone feels robbed here. There's someone here that's real stubborn. Wants to keep doing something. Now someone, if there's evidence of what someone's been doing here. Ace of Cups reverse. Someone feels empty inside. Someone could be dealing, there could be a masculine energy here that also is seeing through something here. Some sort of evidence of something that someone's doing to someone. And trying to injure someone. It's very mean what someone's goals are. There's some sort of evidence. And this group that's connected, trying to block your luck. Someone trying to stop you from, someone got demasked. It has to do with a click, something going on with this group. Having to do with someone's career or job or business. There's a High Priestess reverse in the environment. This person's trying to sell people on a dream. Some sort of adventure. If they go on this adventure, they're going to get the treasure. That's crazy. People are getting injured. They could be losing money. Something about someone's career and someone ruining their life doing this. Yeah. Trying to go against you or getting tempted to go against you. To block you is a trap. I feel like multiple people are realizing something here. You're not lonely. There was something about you being lonely that's really integral to whatever this strategy is. Instead, it's like these people were overindulging and like not fully seeing life pass them by. And now they're realizing everything is not okay. Very, very worried. Worried about some sort of seeing evidence of losing blessings in their own life, going against someone here, getting tempted by something, trying to block a sweetheart is a trap. Two of Pentacles, a lot is changing. They're worried about the changes or stress. There's a lot of they can't keep up with something here. It has to do with breaking a promise. You're living a sweet dream. There's something someone was doing here for money. Very manipulative, energetically manipulative. And karma's playing out. It also has to do with your profession. Someone shouldn't have tried to mess with your... It is not okay for them. Whatever they tried to do here for your business, your career, your job. You're very perseverant. Whatever they did here is a trap. Outcome is a Ten of Pentacles. I feel like that's connected to you and your business and who you're building with, or something very positive. You know, this is generational wealth building or investing or some bigger picture situation that you're working on. It seems to be working out, and someone here is going to feel like they ruined their life when whatever this is takes place. It could be someone who feels like they were supposed to be connected to you and be witnessing whatever this was, but they were after this treasure with this High Priestess reverse, real witchy person here. Someone's getting demasked, and they're also very unapologetic. And also someone here can't apologize to you. There's no way to say sorry. There's nothing they can say. They can't defend their actions. They're getting demasked through some type of karma playing out, having to do with getting tempted. There's some sort of evidence of something that someone took part in here. Someone could have got paid to do something. It's a tower. And that could be like a revelation about somebody participating in something here with this High Priestess reverse. Like, with the promise of some type of a treasure, and it has to do with you being stopped or blocked or stolen from. And a bunch of people seem to have, like, they drank the Kool-Aid, they believe something, and... But there is an event here, though, with this loss. I feel like with the tower here, it's more than just a realization. I feel like the loss has to do with money and true love. And it feels like someone was someone in some type of, like, a trance a little bit, but it's also like they wanted to go on this adventure. I feel like someone agreed with something here. They were being, you know, with this High Priestess reverse, maybe this person is... People are seeing this person as very witchy, that was trying to sell a dream here. And there's this tower. I don't know if this is a revelation or tower could be even, wow, just underneath that we have Devil reverse. Wow, there's more to this reading, because we also have this King of Pentacles reverse and this Page of Swords reverse. It's just... This is the kind of thing that seems like it would be in the news, because the Moon, Devil reverse, Tower, King of Pentacles reverse, Page of Swords reverse, like, this feels very cultish. Like somebody, you know, like all these people were following this person, and this is what they were doing, and it's gonna be in the news, and someone's getting hauled off to jail, and someone's realizing, snapping out of it now that it's like they're going to jail. They're asking themselves how they got here, and this person's the leader. And everyone knows now what someone was doing, what was going on behind closed doors. It does kind of feel like that. It feels dramatic like that. And I guess I keep trying to find something that's more emotional, because that dramatic interpretation just seems very, well, dramatic. I feel like it's got to be something less dramatic than that, because... But it does kind of feel like that, like, you know, somebody banging down the doors to somebody's house or something like that. Because we see evidence of a bunch here, evidence of what someone was doing. But I also feel like there's an emotional loss. There's financial and emotional loss. The Moon, Tower. Also something that someone was hiding here that's very devilish. Very, very toxic. Somebody stalking someone. Somebody slandering and stalking. And it's like lunacy. Tower lunacy. It's total lunacy. I feel like it's exposed, and it's like exposed in a really weird kind of turn of chain of events or something like that. It's like all these people were attacking a Queen of Cups. What's weird is that I'm getting that from this, but I don't feel like it's happened yet, but I feel like it's going to happen in this particular case. It feels like these people got so engrossed in something was like following the leader. You know, it's like following Manson or something like that. It's just very devil moon tower. It's shocking. It's like Jim Jones or Manson, or it's the kind of thing where the details will come out slowly. I don't know if this is connected to what's going on here, but, or if it is, it's almost like it's going to come out later, or it's happening now. But it also could be this is like a revelation. Page of Swords reversed. This is like somebody's obsessed and stalking someone. Some sort of, this feels definitely like some sort of, you know, somebody very unstable stalking someone. King of Pentacles reversed could be the one stalking someone. With this High Priestess reversed, could be a couple doing this. And I feel like people had the propensity to go this far before this happened, but I feel like they continue to do something over and over and over again to the point where it's like they lost themselves and couldn't. It's like losing touch with reality. Doing something over and over and over again here, very manipulative, very dark. And it also has to do with some type of greed or something like that. Not wanting someone else to reach a milestone, like a lot of ego. You know, it's, wow. So, I feel like someone feels cursed. They're heading towards some like horrific misfortune or catastrophe. I feel like someone here is realizing also that they got caught up in a whirlwind of hate. That they lost themselves in a whirlwind of hate for some type of adventure. That there was like some sort of money. That they were like, but it's like they allowed themselves to be led by someone who's, it's like this High Priestess reverse. I feel like they knew what they were doing. It's like the dangling a carrot in front of people's faces. Like, you know, these are the two things that will make somebody respond and keep them, you know, under their thumb or something like that. Just keep making it feel like an adventure and there's a lot of money. And that's it. There's a lot of money coming, or there's a lot of money around. And then there's a lot of gluttony and a lot of self-indulgence. Overindulgence, I should say. Overdoing it. Never really actually getting clarity. Never going within. And in the meantime, there's this bullying going on with the Queen of Cups. But that's really significant because either somebody was actively turned their back on you in order to have this fake adventure, which was actually them ruining their own life, or they participated actively in this, like they agreed in exchange for some type of adventure. They knew exactly what was going on. There was a lot of hate. People, you know, acting out of hate. Jealousy, maybe, with the Devil reverse. You know, this is, and also doing this to a Queen of Cups. Yeah. I feel like there might be a little bit more. What's the main takeaway from this reading? Snake. Talk behind your back. Hypocrisy, lies, pretense. So this has a lot to do with the Page of Swords reverse being some type of slander. So somebody could be realizing that they believed a bunch of lies and were being, or these people told a bunch of lies about you in exchange for some sort of adventure or treasure. because to appease this High Priestess reverse, this very witchy person here, someone's getting demasked, though. That's another thing here. There's something about it being very clear that you're a Queen of Cups. Also that you're very sweet or healing, very balanced. What about these lies? Wheat. Snake. Wheat. Wow, hate. It's truly hate. It's like a group of people acting on hate. Slandering someone because they hate someone. Wow. Slandering and bullying because they hate someone. Slandering and bullying because they hate someone. And they're, whoever these people are, experiencing some type of loss here. There's definitely karma playing out for acting out in hate. Yeah, this, someone lost control of the hate. Lost control because of the hate. Or they lost control because they joined the people who hated you. And they were taking some type of steps here that were very, very devilish. It's not just, you know, hate is never good on its own. But then to, you know, bully someone and slander someone. And we saw profession, so this has to do with somebody slandering someone. And I think there could be jealousy too with the devil reverse. In a group, slandering and bullying someone in a group because they hate them. But I think it went too far is what it is. Is that, I mean, it's you know, bullying at all should never happen, ever. But I think it's like these people lost themselves in the hate. And they didn't see where the line, where they, when they crossed the line. It's like lunacy. But there was also something here, though, where they were getting promised something. They can freely hate you because they're on top and they're going to get this adventure and they get to enjoy seeing you go down. And we saw apology reverse, very little remorse. Very little remorse. And it seems like you're getting this Ten of Pentacles, like the sweet love and this Ten of Pentacles, and somebody ruined their life participating in this. Attacking someone who's very sweet and loving. Timing. Wheat. Next, our current summer. So I feel like that's more closely matching this Ten of Pentacles as far as timing goes, the outcome. Yeah. Wow. Pretty heavy stuff. Tower. Someone's going through a tower. Moon. I feel like there's more to it. Somebody didn't see something with the moon. Sudden change. Someone didn't see something. Sudden change. everything that was built will fall down. So it's also like everything's falling down and not having any clarity to fix it or save themselves. Because I also feel like that's what they wanted for you. Some sort of drastic change connected to some type of gossip, slander, stalking. And it does also give some sort of energy having to do with a car as well. Someone's taking a loss here. Is there something that someone's planning? Because I feel like the reading is over, but why do I feel like there's some sort of intention here? There could be a Gemini, there could be astral travel, could be part of this. It could be something about the way you look, or a glow up, or a level up. A female presenting person, astral travel. Someone could have tried to do something manipulative that's like backfiring. This could be family, or there are family involved, someone's family involved, a Leo could be significant. A female presenting person is in denial here about your good karma. The situation is very toxic. MNOP could be some sort of shame. Something about the moon again. You who the angels love like their baby. Attacking someone who's very, very sweet. There's some sort of lunacy. There's hatred. These people hate someone who's very sweet. Something is not so smart that a Libra did. Something was dangerous. Now it's heartbreaking. Something was very toxic. Somebody is like not stable here at all with that moon. Somebody watching someone, stalking someone is not stable. They could be a Virgo. It's something to do with someone's security. Self-care. It's making someone very sad, like they want to cry. There could be a lot of substance use or handling involved here, particularly with a Gemini. Or an Aquarius. There's something about something that you made. They did something not so smart. Something about something you made. Because the angels love you like their baby. There is some sort of denial here. There could be some sort of conflict over someone being in denial. And over bad karma that's playing out. And a very toxic situation. And some sort of secrets that people are keeping, and this good karma playing out in your life. Something about someone seeing something having to do with your third eye, or someone is trying to look in to see what's going on in your life. Something about romance or something like that. MNOP. Someone did something not so smart because the angels love you like their baby. Someone hears a snake in the grass, looking at someone's abundance. Something about a Leo. Dangerous. Heartbreak. There's something to do with someone really becoming very unstable here, as things come into alignment for you. And there's this good karma playing out. Something about someone looking into a date or something like that with their third eye. Something about love and laughter. Some sort of weird energy coming from mean family. Maybe a female presenting person. A Leo. A Scorpio. seeing, looking, watching. Maybe you're trying to use their third eye. I don't know if all these people know each other. MNOP. So, like, a lot of indulgence here. A male-presenting person did some sort of injustice here. They're also in heartache, heartbreak. There's a lot of secrets still here. Someone could have gone into, or someone was keeping secrets from someone about your Akashic records or something like that. Your third eye. Someone doing something on purpose to you. Having to do with dating, astral travel. Very, very, someone wanted you to get passed on. They would have done anything for you to get passed on. A, B, C, D. Projecting a lot of bad vibes. Bad vibes around these people. Whatever they did is not so smart. Because the angels love you like their baby. They should use caution. Sharing something. It's an injustice. Could have to do with a child as well. Something, some sort of denial about something going on with a child. Someone may be thinking that they could be a King of Cups. They should have been a King of Cups. They're in heartache. They've got all these secrets now they have to deal with. Something about records. Secret records. Maybe that this is also secrets about someone looking into someone. Looking at some... I feel like Akashic records. Something about a divine masculine. Some sort of secrets. A Taurus energy. Somebody's laughing. They think something's funny. About a date. Someone getting passed on, some sort of bad vibes, and also something you made, something having to do with the moon. They thought something was funny. Actually, it's not so smart. I feel like that's what this tower is. That there's, I feel like they're dealing with a lot of weird energy. You could be picking up on it, especially Queen of Cups energy. Weird energy coming from a snake in the grass about your new clothes or your level up or your glow up. If you have children, you know, things are going well. Everyone's taken care of. There's karma playing out here in that sense too with your children. There's something that's the message is that these people did something dangerous to themselves because something is meant to be given to you. And they're being very toxic about it. Keeping something secret here. Having to do with the divine masculine energy. Something to do with adding up the numbers here. Or there could be a mathematician or an accountant that's a Cancer. Watching something. I feel like people are upset having to do with someone. No, they were laughing. They were doing something on purpose, maybe with an Aries. Having to do with a vacation, someone's dating someone. Something to do with someone meditating. They were very arrogant because you're connecting to God and the divine energies. And something about a Sagittarius. Substance use handling, some sort of shame connected to it regarding something you made. People are getting clarity on this whole situation. The snake in the grass has to use more caution. Whoever this is in this family member or this mean family, with whatever they think is funny regarding meditation and God and the divine energies. The Sagittarius. Shame. There's some sort of shame connected to this energy vampire. They should be more careful with whatever they're doing during the moon, or I don't know if this is they're doing something during the moon cycle or whatever they're doing. There's definitely lunacy here, and I feel like this energy is really toxic, so we're going to leave it there for now. If you resonate, I hope that it helps, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.